Hello friends, welcome to Dev's Institute. Today we will learn octal number system and its convergence. Octal number system is a number system with base 8. It has 8 different numbers in the system, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Like decimal number system, base is 10 and numbers are 0 to 9. Here it is octal number system. As it is octal, base is 8 because it contains 0 to 7 numbers. First, we'll see how to convert a decimal number into an octal number. So consider this is my first number 330 in decimal, and I have to convert it into octal. While converting decimal number to octal number, we have to divide decimal number by 8 and we have to write the remainders for each the step. So for example, first we'll divide 330 by 8. When you divide 330 by 8, you will get quotient as 41 and remainder 2. In next step, we'll divide this quotient by 8. So 41 is divided by 8. In this step, quotient is 5 and remainder is 1. In next step, 5 is divided by 8. Quotient is 0 and remainder is 5. We'll stop at this step as we have reached to quotient 0. So we have to repeatedly divide by 8 the different quotients we get throughout this division till we get quotient as 0. So here remainders are 2, 1, 5, and we have to write those remainders in reverse order to get octal number. So 330 in decimal is equal to 5, 1, 2 in octal. One more example, 28 in decimal. So 28 divided by 8 will give you quotient 3, remainder 4. Because 8 threes are 24, so quotient is 3 and remainder is 4. Next, 3 will be divided by 8. 3 divided by 8 will give you quotient 0, remainder 3. We'll stop at this step because the quotient has reached to 0. Now we have to write this remainders in reverse order, that is 3, 4. So 28 in decimal is equal to 3, 4 in octal number system. Next is, this is about the integer part, means when your number is whole number. Suppose your number is a fractional number, fractional part, 0.6875 in decimal, and you have to convert it into octal. So for integer part, we divide it by 8. For fractional part, we multiply it by 8. So 0.6875 are multiplied by 8 will give you 5.5. So we remember this integer part 5 and we consider only fractional part for next multiplication. So 0.5 multiplied by 8 will give you 4 and fractional part is 0, 4.0. So we remember this 4. As we have reached fractional part as a 0, we'll stop the process here, and 0.6875 in decimal is equal to 0.54 in octal. I repeat, we take fractional part, we multiply it by 8 and we get some number. So we note down the integer part of the first multiplication and we consider fractional part for next multiplication. So here 0.5 is considered for next multiplication. 0.5 multiplied by 8 will give you 4.0. So we'll note down 4, but as next fractional part is 0, we'll stop the process here. So 0.6875 in decimal is represented as 0.54 in octal number system. We'll take one more example which contains integer part and fractional part. So here number is 121.15625 in decimal, and we have to find out its equivalent octal. So for integer part we'll use divide by 8 method, and for fractional part we'll use multiply by 8 method. So here 121 divided by 8 will give you quotient 15, remainder 1. 15 divided by 8 will give you quotient 1, remainder 7. 1 divided by 8 will give you quotient 0 and remainder 1. So 121 is equal to 171 in octal. For fractional part, we multiply it by 8. For integer part, we divide it by 8. For fractional part, we multiply it by 8. So 0.15625 multiplied by 8 will give you 1.25. So we'll note down this one, integer part. 0.25 multiplied by 8 will give you 2.0. As fractional part has reached to 0, we'll note down this 2. So integer part and fraction part togetherly, this 121 converted to octal will give you 171, and this 0.15625 will be equal to 0.12. So total answer is 171.12 in octal, which is equivalent of this in decimal. This is about decimal to octal. Now octal to decimal conversion. You have 151, which is octal, base is 8, and you have to convert it into decimal. So while converting decimal to octal, we divide by 8. Here we multiply by power of 8, not 8 just, but power of 8. So here first number is multiplied by 8 raised to 0. Second number is multiplied by 8 raised to 1. And third number is multiplied by 8 raised to 2. Likewise, the powers will be get increased as the number of digits will be get increased. So here, this 1 into 8 raised to 2 plus 5 into 8 raised to 1 plus 1 into 8 raised to 0. So 8 raised to 0 is 1. 1 multiplied by 1 is 1, 5 adds up 40, and 1 into 8 raised to 2 is 64. We add up this all to get the number as 151. Sorry, it's not 151, it's actually 105. Then, next is octal to decimal conversion with the fractional part. So before fractional part means this side, from this octal point, left side of the octal point, we multiplied by 8 raised to 0, 8 raised to 1, 8 raised to 2, like that. So after this point, we multiplied by 8 raised to minus 1, 8 raised to minus 2, 8 raised to minus 3, 8 raised to minus 4. So here 1 multiplied by 8 raised to minus 1, 2 multiplied by 8 raised to minus 2, 1 multiplied by 8 raised to minus 3, and 5 multiplied by 8 raised to minus 4. By adding up this all, we get this number. Integer and fractional part. So here 425.123 is octal number, and we have to get its decimal number. So like we do for integer, 5 multiplied by 8 raised to 0 plus 2 multiplied by 8 raised to 1 plus 4 multiplied by 8 raised to 2. 4 multiplied by 8 raised to 2 plus 2 multiplied by 8 raised to 1 plus 5 multiplied by 8 raised to 1 plus 1 multiplied by 8 raised to minus 1. 5 multiplied by 8 raised to 0, and here after this octal point it will be 8 raised to minus 1 plus 2 into 8 raised to minus 2 plus 3 into 8 raised to minus 3. So this will give you value this 277.16210937 5. So this just you have to do normal multiplication and then you have to add up all the terms. Next part is octal to binary conversion. So this is the octal number 3672 and we have to convert it into binary. A normal method is first you have to convert from octal to decimal or decimal to binary, or another is you can directly convert octal to binary. So while converting octal to binary, every digit in an octal is represented using 3-bit binary number. Why 3-bit? Because octal numbers are from 0 to 7, so maximum number is 7 and we require 3 bits to represent 7. So every number in an octal is represented using 3-bit binary number to convert it into binary number. So here 3 will be represented as 011, 6 will be represented as 110, 7 is 111 and 2 is 010. So 3672 in octal is equal to 011, 110, 111, 010 in binary. And if you convert this binary into decimal, you will get octal into decimal conversion. Next is integer part and fractional part. So similar like we do for integer, we do for fractional. So here also 3 is represented using binary, 3-bit binary 011, 6110, 7111, 2010, dot 1 is represented 001, 2 is represented 010, and 1 is represented as 001. So this is the conversion from octal to binary. So same bits are written here to convert octal to binary. 011 110 110 dot 001 010 001. Now binary to octal conversion. So consider you have binary number and you have to convert it into octal. Again here we have to make a group of 3 binary bits. Okay, so for integer part, this is only the integer part, so we'll make a group of 3 from right to left, that is from LSB to MSB. So first group is 110, its equivalent decimal is 6. Octal, not decimal. 110, its equivalent octal is 6. 110, its equivalent octal is 6. Next group is 101, its equivalent is 5. And last one is 111, its equivalent octal is 7. So 7, 5, 6, 6. So this is the octal number for this binary number. Just we have to make a group of 3 bits. This is first group, then second, then third, then fourth. Now if you have fractional part, similar to this, we have to make a group of 3 from this point onwards. So 011 is the first group, its equivalent octal is 3. Next group is 001 and its equivalent octal is 1. So this binary converted into its equivalent octal number. Okay. So this is the final result. Now what if the binary number is, or the number of digits in a binary are not multiple of 3. Okay. So here this is first group. While making binary to octal conversion, this is first group 110 that we converted to 6. The next group contains only 10, that is 2 bits are there, and we have to form a group of 3. So what we do, we append 10 here at the MSB. So this will make a group of 3, 0, 1, 0 and its equivalent octal is 2. So this is equal to 26 in octal. Similarly, for fractional part also, suppose this is first group is 0, 1, 0, its equivalent octal is 2. Next, we have only 1, so to make it 3, we'll append 2 zeros to MSB, which will give us 1. Next, for the fractional part, first group is 1, 1, 0, which is 6. Next, we have 1, so we'll append 2 zeros here. So 1, 0, 0 will give you 4. So this is your final answer. So this is all about octal number system and its conversion in decimal and binary. If you like the video, press like button given below the video. Subscribe to channel. If you have any doubts, you can ask me through comment section. Thank you very much.